Hello, televiewers. Good evening and welcome to this other edition of Prime Hour on My Media Prime. We are sorry for the late start. This day we are going to be looking at the increasing attacks on military personnel. There was a case in Momo Division, and today there was an attack at the Matazem Santa checkpoint where we know that two gendarmes are said to have died and a policeman. While four died in Momo Division the other day, alongside one of our colleagues, in fact, my classmate. We are going to be talking about this increasing attacks. Is this a new strategy by separatist fighters as far as the ongoing war in the southwest and northwest regions are concerned? We also are going to be looking at this key issue, a crisis raised by many Cameroonians concerning the national identification card, which has become a goal, very difficult to come by, with many persons who say for 2-3 years, months, 6 months, 9 months, they have been unable to get in possession of their ID cards. We are going to be discussing this with our panelists, two of whom are already here. I'm sure the others are still caught in traffic, terrible traffic in Douala. We are in the company of Ebako Andrin, who is a Pan-Africanist. Good evening and welcome.
Thank you very much. Welcome, Leonard, and thank you to the other panelists and to all the viewers at this hour. Happy New Year to everyone.
We also are in the company of Prince Joel Mukage. Good evening and welcome.
Good evening to you, Mr. Liu. Good evening to Atemi Bako, and Happy New Year to him. Good evening to all those watching My Media Prime and Prima particularly. Special good evening to those watching in the northwest region of Cameroon.
We are expecting the arrival of the representative of the CPDM party and that of the Cameroon Renaissance Movement. I'll start with you. You certainly are a journalist. You have been gathering what Cameroonians are going through with respect to this ID card. What are some of the stories you hear out there?
Sure, Mr. Leo, Cameroonians, many of them, feel that there is something that is going on wrong so far as the production of ID cards is concerned in Cameroon. Mm-hmm. Because a majority will tell you that they need to do their ID cards more than one time before it comes out. And at times, you need to go and they stamp the ID once, twice, thrice, and at times you even get tired. The question they're asking themselves is, what is not going on well? It is very true that at one time, those who are concerned with the production of ID cards, because at times, we even go close to those who are concerned, like the commissioners, the police officers, and want to find out from them what is actually not going on well. And what they'll tell you is that, if you find somebody whose ID card doesn't come out, is maybe in one way or the other, the person had distorted information in his birth certificate. But we've had persons who have seen persons who have more than an ID card. I feel that the issue with ID cards is something that, Ms. Aliu, that is really creating a lot of problems, because so many persons cannot actually carry on their day-to-day activities because of the lack of ID cards. There are those who cannot travel because they've had their ID cards stamped more than once and they are very tired. So it's actually affecting the day-to-day activities of Cameroonians. And they are like, when will this nightmare be over? We believe that with the outing of the man in charge of national security, that is Martin Bargangeli, today at the press, we are believing that in the days ahead, something is going to be done about the ID. Because, Ms. Aliu, an ID card, I believe after your birth certificate, an ID card should be the second document that is indispensable. That is what makes a Cameroonian maybe different from a Nigerian. It's your national ID card. And if Cameroonians keep complaining, so many of them, when you ask them about ID card, so many are very bitter. The general tone that Cameroonians have, so far as ID card is concerned, Ms. Aliu, is that of anger. They do not understand why they should not, as Cameroonians, have their ID cards, though they feel that they have gone through the due processes that one needs in order to have an ID card. I just believe, like I said before, that with the outing of Martin Bargangeli today, the man in charge of national security and the person who signs all ID cards, we're looking better for better days ahead.
Okay, Andre Natemebaku, how do we explain that an ID card is something that's so essential to almost every adult Cameroonian, yet very difficult to come by in the 21st century?
Mitalio, it's quite funny and quite embarrassing to find out that a nation like Cameroon will have a problem whereby citizens are crying not having their ID cards either renewed or not having their ID cards being issued or not even having an identification document. You see, these are some of the imbalances and some of the institutions which are not really being put well in place to be able to serve the public, because an ID card by the official cost by the state is 2,800 francs. You are eligible to obtain an ID card, but today now it has become a difficult issue. So the question here is, what is the challenge and what is the government doing to take care of this issue, because it absolutely distorts and deprives people of their daily activity and other official and legal proceedings and even traveling. So these are issues where if we really want to see how the economy and movement and mobilization of network should flow, the government is supposed to make these ID cards so available in all their stations, whereby people who went there to do their ID cards, it shouldn't take, it's normally, Mr. Liu, it should take maximum 1 week and you should get your ID card. Normally, maximum 1 week your ID card should come out, because you are paying for the ID card, and it's more of like the money which is given to the state goes to the state's treasury. So it's not as if the state is giving you the ID card for free. The citizens are paying for their ID card, and this should not take more than a week. So it is quite embarrassing to see how the issue of ID card can halt the activities of people, because there are some that they have those receipts which were even issued, they are even torn and you cannot even read the names on it. You can't even identify the photos on it. And now, as Cameroon being what it is, now there are other government law enforcement officers who are now making another business inside of their profession by gaining, making extra profit for people who don't have ID cards, and people whose ID card are expired, and people whose ID card are not in good condition whereby they cannot identify the holder of that ID card. And so this is a state which, Mr. Liu, I think that the government should really do much, and also the law enforcement officer should also know that we have a problem of ID card in Cameroon, which I don't even understand how can an ID card which is being printed is becoming a problem. Where I can, it might as well be because of security reasons, like he also did mention of people who may give wrong informations, and probably those informations have shown up in the machine twice or thrice, whereby an ID card cannot be issued to that individual because of wrong information. So these are some of the things whereby the government should be able to apply different methods and see that all citizens are being identified and their ID card should come out at the valid period, so that life can move forward and movement can go ahead. So these are the issues, Mr. Liu.
When you say maybe they have information, that is, a document come to you and you discover that there is already an information on the server about so and so, what stops you from deleting the existing one and then issuing the ID card or calling the person so that he served?
That is a good question, because for you to establish an ID card, you must also have a document,
court declaration,
all those things. Now, using your birth certificate, so that is what I'm trying to say, that there are some, this really happened, Mr. Liu, even right at the level of the birth certificate, there are mistakes that people do at the level of the councils. You see what I'm trying to say? So are the people at the bureau now that manages the information to be able to produce ID cards to certain individuals, especially like, for example, like those, maybe they had lost the identification document and they went there for renewal, you come to realize now that the two information that are put on the table concerning a particular individual does not correspond. So these are some of the challenges also they have. You see, Cameroon...
But now, the nation is there to serve its citizens.
Exactly.
You know that without this ID card, this person can't do this. That
now
the person is penalized. Are you not trained? Are you not recruited?
I understand that very well, and that is where the challenge now becomes at the level of the database management.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm trying to say? Because it's not being managed. It's not an analog system. It's a centralized, computerized system,
mm,
whereby the information should be accurate. So it is just like, for example, which of the names should the person absolutely put in the machine? You see what I'm trying to say? So at that level, it becomes very difficult and very challenging. And that is why sometimes they will, even at the level of passport, they will tell some individuals that you have made errors on your names, and you should be able to rectify this error, and there are procedures for you to amend those errors. So this is what I'm trying to say, that when you are going to send the information into the system, that is exactly where the people may be having a chance. So even if you are going to delete this number, these names, to put this other name, you cannot really identify which of which really belongs, that is, goes in order to that particular individual.
The person is not in space. You can invite the person so that the person...
That is where the communication problem now lies. That is where the masses are suffering. And these are some of the things whereby the government should go extra mile to make it so, in such a way that when people establish ID cards, you have your contact number, which is also followed. They should be able to call you, like how MTN calls people to have certain verifications. You know, customer service, call them, verify. If the names which you have, want to put in the machine, is actually your name, the individual confirms. And you ask, probably in a year today, you can have a NEO coming, put Meta at your home without you going to a NEO office. They have a procedure on WhatsApp. You send your information, you send your localization, you send certain information, and then everything is done. They only ask you go and pay and send a copy of your receipt before you know they come. And the government can do all of this. This is what we call about customer service. That's why I'm saying that the citizens are paying for those ID cards. And the government should be able to be flexible enough to also serve the public. That is very important.
Yeah, but the duration, you have to stay for 3 months. Other persons will stay for 6 months, 9 months. How do we even understand all of this?
Yeah, Ms. Aliyah,
isn't it also because the production process is not done by Cameroonian company? Eh?
Sure, Ms. Aliyah, there is a pertinent question that you asked Ms. Athem about the fact that it is true that some people thwart their information from the communique today that the delegate in charge of national security, Martin Bargangele, says that 3 million Cameroonians have changed their information and it becomes very difficult to process their documents. He again says that there is 10,000 ID cards that are produced every day. Look at the number, 10,000 ID cards that are produced every day. And he says that with the fact that there is another center that has been created in Garoua, it has increased to 15,000.
Yes.
Now, Mr. Leo, if you take 15,000 ID cards that are produced a day,
multiply by 30.
You multiply by 30. And you want to think about a year, you will discover that maybe still at the level of his own communication, there was something that was incorrect, because we will not understand why a Cameroonian will go for an ID card, wait for 3 months, goes back where he did the ID card, cannot have it.
When 10,000 are produced every day.
When 10,000 are produced every day. Now goes back and you're given another 3 months. You go after the 3 months, you come back, it's the same ball game. I just feel that, Mr. Leo, and because when we do ID cards, if there is one aspect which is very truthful, is the fact that when most of us do our ID cards, we know those around there. Because when you go to maybe a police station to do your ID card, around that area they have auxiliary staff. And some of the auxiliary staff know you very well. Which means that at one time, if you want to even distort information, what stops them? You cannot go, Mr. Liu, this ID card stuff takes a lot of processes. You need a certificate of non-conviction. You need a court judgment. All these things, they take a process. Now, it means that before you get to the final stage, before you're even given what the Frenchman called a RCPC, you must have taken all legal procedures that shows that you are viable to have an ID card.
Mm-hmm.
Now, why should the ID card not come out? Because you took a non-conviction that shows that you are a free citizen. You've taken a court declaration that comes from a court. You've taken all that issue, all that different stages. Now, at the level of production, what stops the ID card from coming out? That's the question he asked, Ms. Athem. And I believe that even at the level of the machines, these faults could be detected. If your name used to be Prince Joel, maybe Prince Joel Kum and you've changed Kum to put Mokage, nothing stops the machine from detecting, because when you go for a court judgment is linked to your area of birth. It means that there must be something that is linked to your birth. It means that when you look at the whole show, there is something that is not on, that is not going on well. There is either a manipulation that is ongoing within, from where your ID card is stamped to where it is supposed to be produced. And Ms. Alio, there is something too. An ID card, like we mentioned before now, is an indispensable tool in the hands of every citizen. I've had to see uniform officers pull people down from traveling that your ID card have expired. And these same people who have an expired ID find it difficult from having another ID card. They go and you're given a document that says, okay, you should hold this document, it will permit you use for 6 months. What does now somebody, Ms. Alio, who had a valid ID card, the ID has expired, cannot have another ID card? Is it now? Is it because his information is not good? No, it's no longer the level of information. I just believe that so far as this ID card stuff is concerned, there is something that is not going on well.
There is something that's not going on well. Good evening, Mr. Leo. Good program. Sad to see people dying on both sides of the conflict. This shows that the problem in the Northwest and Southwest regions is far from being under control, as the regime claims. Ngole Hene is writing from Limba. Good evening to you, Ngole. Andin is writing from Bamenda. Good evening, Mr. Liu and crew. I made 2 IDs in 4 years now, still using the recipe to date. Can't do any important transaction. Hope the government really does something on this ID issue. Okay, our government has just given room for police commissioners to swear their bank accounts. We are like strangers in our own country. Honestly, I wonder how emergence will be realized with this system. Terence is writing from Mutengene. The ID card issue is a business. To renew a receipt is at least 1,000 francs. At every checkpoint, you are bound to 1,000 francs. My ID card expired. The old one was used to create a new one. See, today I have never have a new one. Sarkozy is writing from Kumbu. Good evening to you, Sarkozy. Mr. Liu, the guys at the identification units are making fast business from Cameroonians with turnout for ID cards. On Tuesday, I spent 10,000 francs at Bambili police to establish my ID, even though it's boldly written at the entrance that it costs 2,800. JN is writing from Bamenda. Good evening, and Cyberty from Kumbu. Surprised to hear that ID cost 2,800 francs. Spent 25,000, yet the ID card is not there. Mr. Kum, this topic is very important and make us want to ask that what is happening to the most important thing in Cameroon called ID? I say so because the government do not care if Cameroonians have jobs or medication or roads, but the government cares if they must have ID card, yet they cannot produce it. They have just made it difficult for bribe. That's all. There is nothing like double something. Chief Leke is writing from Boya. Almost everybody is complaining. Is this a business that is done? Cameroonians are really suffering. Seemingly, some people are contented somewhere doing their business.
Mr. Liu, there are many factors to look as far as the issuing of the ID card in Cameroon. That is also another aspect.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, today in Cameroon, when you are given a job, you create another job inside that job that has been given to you. And that has been the lifestyle of every Cameroonian, right down to the law enforcement officers. We have seen that on the road because it's quite shameful. A good example would be, for example, in Douala, where the roads which are given to SATOM to fix, and the roads were unable or not properly well dressed up for citizens to use those roads. What happens is that when there is a mass traffic due to the bad sectors of the road that were given to SATOM to repair, now instead of the police officers to turn and tell the government that these roads, we just came from fixing these roads, why are we getting traffic? Why do you increase our work when we should instead
be relieved from the responsibility that we had. That is why we were fixing these roads. What instead do they do? They stand somewhere to seize the advantage of those that are fed up with the traffic and who are trying to make their way using another method, and now they fall on you to extort money from you. So you come to realize that people don't find fault where there is fault. They go and find fault where there is no fault, and that is what we are suffering today in Cameroon. The issue of ID cards, if you want your ID card, Mr. Aliou, probably to come out in 2 days. If you have 150,000 fans, you get it probably even the same night. If you went there in the afternoon, in the evening, the same whoever was signing, we call and send it over. You not even need to go there. They will bring it right over to you. So you come to realize that Cameroon has now become a place where it is money that makes it work. It is no longer morality. So the integrity and dignity amongst Cameroonians is no longer the case anymore. And that is why I kept saying that Cameroonians have developed a mentality where they live in Cameroon as tourists, as strangers, who one day when they finish, they pack their bags and go into another land. And these are some of the things that are causing our young men and women to travel out into Asia and other places, and end of the day became slaves, because we are treating ourselves as people who don't belong in this country. So, Mr. Aliou, that is a very pertinent point that you just mentioned. I think that is why the government should be able to build agencies. The agencies we have for fighting of corruption and all of this, they are very ineffective. Each time a commission is assigned, people always use it to abuse power. You come even right to the normal level of the local council that has acceded out the contract to another private company to manage traffic within the town. If you see what those boys are doing in town, you ask yourself, are these really Cameroonians? They don't have no form of education, no training. Their work was supposed to educate road users and give you warning, so that next time if you repeat the same fault, you'll be punished. Since we don't have a centralized technological system of managing of a certain institution, it has become now that once you are working with the council, or once you have this opportunity, whether you are a police officer, you earn more money than the salary that is given to you. So we don't have agencies that are able to check people's financial dealings, check people's background history. You will not pick somebody who has never had the opportunity to make one kobo on his own, and you take him and put him where he sees an opportunity to take advantage over his own countrymen. These are the kind of things, Mr. Aliou, that we are saying that we need competency. We need people who are trained and who are equipped and ready to deliver their job description, and not people who, when they are being employed, they create another job inside the same job that they are giving them, and now begin to make money bigger than the one that they are getting. And Mr. Aliou, let me just say this finally. That is why in civilized society, take for example, if you are earning 40,000 francs a day, it is just virtually impossible for you to buy a car of 2.5 million. Because you cannot save. They know how much you pay as your rent. The government has that information. Know how much you pay per transportation, and if you are married, how many children. So they can know your standard of living. But you see somebody who is earning 100,000 and lives and spends more money than somebody who is like somebody who is spending earning 10 million francs, and the government doesn't bother. Nobody bothers to check the financial dealing of that individual. Definitely the person must be stealing money. And you come to realize now that the people who are working hard don't get, they don't deserve what they get, and the people who are not working are the people who are, this is how the system is. You protect the people, the criminals that are supposed to be behind bars, and then you penalize those that are supposed to excel the economy. So this is very sad, Mr. Aliou.
Okay, good evening to you, Munzi Beta. Yungo Dixon, who says, Mr. Aliou, I paid 450,000 francs CFA for my ID card to come out in Yaoundé in 2019. It's business. How do we understand that an individual has to pay up to that amount? Yungo Dixon is writing from Libreville in Gabon. Kliga Eli, good evening to you. Julius Chair, good evening to you and to you. Feko Cameroon, Prosperity J, good evening to you. Nkai Abadayan, and to you. Nku Nsinwe. And all of you watching us on social media, I say special evening to you. Guys, now, this issue of ID card has been dragging for years today. very difficult for Yaoundé to deliver, getting to the point where people now have to come and pay huge sums of money to be served. Isn't it also the issue of over-centralization of this production? Almost every ID card in Cameroon has to be produced in Yaoundé.
Sure, Mr. Liu, if you want your ID card, just like Mr. Atemebako was saying, if you want your ID card in 2-3 days, maximum 5 days, you go to Mvan in Yaoundé, where the ID cards are done. And those who want, have people, not one or two, have guys who've had issues with their ID cards, where they've done it more than once. And once you go to Mvan in Yaoundé, the next week, they are coming back with a valid ID card. Now, Mr. Leo, when I looked at this issue of ID card, far from the centralization of power in Yaoundé, there are some pertinent questions that I asked myself. When you want to do a school ID card, I want to take the case of the University of Boya, for instance. The ID card is almost automatic. You agree with me. As you do it, it is kaka, they give you, you go. I want to believe that if these ID card machines or whatever thing is used to produce the machines, if they could struggle that these things or the machines are in each division, because the delegate for national security, Matemba Rangiretu, they said that Cameroon has a total of 280
centers
so far as identification of IDs are concerned, 50 mobile areas. Now you ask yourself, how many divisions are in Cameroon? If Cameroon can pride itself to have 280,
yeah, instead of every division, why not produce them at the regional headquarters?
That could still be another way, Mr. Leo, because if they could do it in such a way that Cameroon has just 10 regions, if they could do it in such a way that each region has a possibility of the making their ID cards within that region, we'll not be having this problem. Because this problem at times comes from the fact that, Mr. Liu, for these things, because when you go and do an ID card, say in one small village, everything needs to be assembled and forwarded
to the divisional headquarters.
To the
regional headquarters and to Yaoundé.
Now, in the course of this process, we cannot for sure, man makes machines and machines do fail them. We cannot certainly also confirm or ascertain that every information goes right to where it's supposed to be. But like you propose, if everything was done at the level of each region, it becomes very easy, and the cumbersome nature of Yaoundé will be reduced. Because this issue of ID card is something I believe, Ms. Aliou, like the telespectators are saying, is something that needs to really be treated with a lot of consideration, because I know so many Cameroonians who cannot travel because they have an issue with ID card. And when you know that you don't have a valid ID card, while living in a country where it's very easy, as you're traveling, the driver will tell you, those who don't have their ID cards, tell me. And once you know that you don't have an ID card, you tell the driver, he knows how he's going to walk your way through, maybe from Douala right up to Yaoundé. And these are some of the things that are killing the whole thing, and they are making things not to really happen the way they are supposed to happen.
Okay. Good evening, Mr. Liu, and Happy New Year to all of you in the studio. This ID card issue is total madness. It didn't mind almost a year today. Not till out. Was told to go to Yaoundé on whose account and where to do I stay, that I should check my info, what I did, and everything was okay. I'm tired. B. Rita, writing from Mile 6, Mancon. Good evening to you, B. Rita. Greetings to all in the studio. I don't know if this government is serious. I made my first ID in 2015. The original came with errors. I was asked by the officer to submit it alongside my birth certificate for correction, which I did instantly. I went there severally, yet it never came out. Then I was asked to come to do a new one, which I did. Anytime it expires, you go to the police station and complain. They say, come and make a new one. I have done it 3 times, yet nothing better. Okay, Paul B. John is writing from Yaoundé. Good evening to you, Paul. Good evening, Mr. Liu. I think I buy into Mr. Ebako's point for the database to be more developed, and government should really look into this ID card matter, because it has become a money-making issue. Atemebako, do you think there is an acute crisis that may lead to something, it may lead to a social uprising or something similar to that if care is not taken?
Mr. Liu, I think that's...
Are we in the middle of a crisis?
Yeah, we are, and I think it's a very pertinent point you have just you've raised up there. Because when I look at the structure in Cameroon, I wonder, I try to diagnose what is going on in the mind of the CPDM regime. I don't know how they are really looking at Cameroonians, because it seems as if Cameroonians today have become commodities whereby everybody raises up to see who they can buy. Because if you stand with the face of having 350 political opposition parties, that makes, psychologically, it tells me somehow that CPDM chooses who and who should be given ID card or not. Because at the end of the day, they are the one managing the issuing of the ID card. So are we saying now that the alleged sins of these 350 political opposition parties are now falling on the common Cameroonian? Because if all Cameroonians were CPDM, I'm sure all of us would have bought an ID card with no issue. There will be no challenge. So the fact that we are having this much divisions make the government become at a very skeptical position, in such a way that they look at things very differently, because Cameroonians, as far as I'm concerned, are split into 350 different opinions. So you come to realize that the more of these opposition parties that we are even having is not even in the common good of the local Cameroonians. So I am saying that CPDM should be able to set aside or
is it the CPDM or the police?
No. I'm coming here, Mr. Liu.
Okay.
When we talk of the police, who controls the police in Cameroon here is the government. And the government is the CPDM. So when I talk of the police, Mr. Liu, to enter into police is massive. It's better than that you have even won 100 million, because there these boys understand that they have been giving an unlimited access to resources, because they know that in their job description they can make more money than even what a businessman who has 10 employees outside makes a month. So what I'm saying here, Mr. Liu, is that we are tired of this. Cameroonians living as though they are strangers in their own land. Because at the end of the day, you come to realize that it will take us, I still repeat that, countries that are developed, change can come from any angle. It can equally come from the government, equally as it can still come from the masses. I have seen families, very poor families, very poor backgrounds, and children that came out from the family, one man changes the face of that family. So it takes the competency and integrity of citizens who love their nation. Let me give you a very good example, Mr. Liu. I'll give you a very good example. If you go to a petrol station like Bokom, Tradex, for example, you realize that in some of their stations, they don't have the customer service, they don't have services where clients that come there to fuel their car can probably sit and talk business and maybe have coffee or have something to drink or have even something, some small chewable. Now you come to realize that now the reason why most of those stations are not developed is the management. So you realize that, for example, the government may give you an enabling environment. Now it takes the population to develop and to maintain and to bring out the beauty of that place. So you go, you come to this particular station, you realize that this is different. You come to this other one, you see that this is different. So it all has to do with the management. For this country to be to come normal, it would take, Mr. Liu, majority of the work that has to be done in this country needs to come from the masses, not from the government. If the government is unable, the masses can make those changes.
You want the masses to start producing the ID cards?
That is not what I'm talking about, Mr. Liu. This is another good point you have just raised up. If, for example, you are traveling and a policeman brings you down out of the car, that your ID card is probably expired. You know what the driver does and all the other passengers? See how you sort through the problem with the man. See how you can fix the problem with the man. You see what I'm trying to say? Give something, and if you don't give, they are ready to go and leave you. In the few occasions I've been, I don't tolerate that. I don't leave you. If a policeman dares to mess up with you, I will teach the policeman a lesson. I will not let you go, because Cameroonian needs to learn to stand behind Cameroonians when Cameroonians are in trouble. But we have developed the mentality that because you are in trouble and it's not me, it's not my business.
That is not how a country is supposed to work. We must have solidarity. We must have that brother who love. We must understand that it is us that is.
As if somebody is brought down the vehicle, everybody stays.
No, everybody stays down, okay. And you realize that that teaches that officer a lesson.
Okay,
honestly speaking, if it happens 1, 2, 3 times, you won't get it anymore.
Okay, Monsieur Youtfis, you came late. Bonsoir et bienvenue. Mais qu'est-ce qui se passe-t-il avec les candidats? Presque tout le monde pleure. Hein?
Je m'excuse déjà. Une fois de plus pour le retard, mais je suis en route depuis.
Ok.
Les aléas de la route et les civismes de bon nombre de nos concitoyens. Mais déjà, je voulais entamer mon propos à présenter d'abord les condoléances du Rassemblement démocratique du peuple camerounais à l'ensemble des familles qui ont été endeuillées. Sur le pas la série des attentats et des massacres de ces 2-3 derniers jours. Pour revenir à la carte nationale d'identité, nous avons connu cet après-midi une conférence de presse de la direction de la délégation générale à la sécurité nationale qui était donc conduite là par son secrétaire général qui a fait le point et nous nous félicitons de certain nombre d'informations très utiles qui nous ont été données. Je vais par là vous dire que on nous fait comprendre que 245 000 cartes nationales d'identité établis sont dans les commissariats en souffrance dans l'attente du retrait. Cela ne veut pas dédouaner le fait que si on cherche sa carte nationale d'identité, qu'on puisse attendre, mais on se dit quand même que si 245 000 cartes nationales d'identité sont en souffrance et établies déjà et on ne les retire pas, il y a un problème. Autre chose, il nous a été révélé au cours de cette conférence de presse qu'il fallait sécuriser le fichier de la carte nationale d'identité de par un certain nombre de pratiques. Le copaniste de tout à l'heure, M. Atebako, a dit beaucoup de choses, mais en fait, j'ai eu l'impression qu'il avait mélangé plein de sujets, et la corruption, et la carte nationale d'identité, et les TRADEX, et le carburant, le service, ainsi de suite. Donc, enfin, le téléspectateur peut se perdre un tout petit peu. C'est pour cela que vous avez adopté une thématique. À partir de cette thématique-là, on peut en discuter pour que les uns et les autres sortent un peu plus édifiés. Nous nous félicitons du fait que si vous amenez votre véhicule sans publicité dans une station Tradex, vous êtes sûr d'avoir le même carburant partout où vous allez. Et le job de base de marketeur comme Tradex, c'est d'abord la distribution des produits pétroliers. Donc, si vous êtes sûr que la distribution de ces produits pétroliers dans l'ensemble des stations-services de cette entreprise, c'est le même produit, c'est la même qualité, le même prix est garanti et stabilisé. Ça voudrait dire que le reste, on appelle ça ce soir. À ce soir de confort, pour le temps mis.
Presque tout le monde pleure. Hein. Il y a des gens qui ont été écrits. Ils ont fait ça au moins 3 fois. Toujours rien.
Voilà. Il nous a été révélé que nous avions plein de nos concitoyens. Près de 3 millions de concitoyens qui sont en train d'utiliser 2-3 formes d'identité. C'est-à-dire que quoi? Si vous vous appelez M. Koum Léonard, vous venez établir la carte, la première identification, c'est M. Koum Léonard. Vous revenez 10 ans plus tard, vous dites M. Léonard Koum, c'est déjà 2 personnes.
Oui.
Et à partir de ce moment-là, il y a blocage. Ensuite, ça c'est seulement au niveau du jeu du nom. Il y a d'autres, ils vont écrire, le père, c'est peut-être prince. Et la mère, c'est ceci.
Lorsqu'il revient, il change. Donc, il faut d'abord qu'il y ait harmonisation et continuité de ces informations, parce qu'en réalité, on crée cela. Les problèmes
est-ce que pourquoi ils sont payés? Est-ce qu'ils sont aussi payés pour faciliter la tâche à cela, non? Si quelqu'un fait ce genre d'erreur, qu'est-ce qui vous empêche de les appeler, que venez rectifier ces choses, ou vous effacez l'autre fichier et puis...
Le problème qui se pose souvent, c'est que le même individu lui-même, il est même incapable parfois, ou bien ne vous apporte pas la preuve. C'est pour ça que parfois, on vous demande un certificat d'individualité.
Il y a quelqu'un qui a écrit que je suis allé, on m'a dit ceci, apporter ceci, j'ai apporté. Oui. On m'a dit que refaites ça, il a refait, mais ça ne bouge pas.
Non, il a été révélé au cours de cette conférence de presse cet après-midi, qu'il y a eu d'abord un problème d'ordre structurel technique. C'est-à-dire que le passage de l'ancienne version de la carte nationale d'identité.
Voilà, en 2016.
Oui, non, mais c'est-à-dire que le fichier a entre être pris en main. La production en termes de nombre de cartes d'identité par jour qui est de 10 000 sur l'ensemble des 280
points. Que 10 000 cartes sont produites au Cameroun chaque jour?
Chaque jour. C'est ça. Maintenant, vous voyez, au lieu que je me mets à discuter sur cela, il faudrait que quelqu'un nous apporte d'autres informations.
Okay.
Mais les informations qui ont été rendues publiques. Et donc, la direction générale de la Société nationale s'engage à répondre sur ces informations, c'est qu'elle a une capacité de production de 10 000 cartes nationales d'identité, si toutes les conditions sont réunies. Et qu'elle est en train de vouloir élargir cette capacité de production à 15 000 avec le pool de production au niveau de Garoua.
Oui.
Donc, complété avec ces 280 points d'identification et 50 points d'identification mobile. Mais, n'oublions pas que le problème majeur, c'est sur l'identification, c'est sur l'information de base, c'est sur la capacité à pouvoir sécuriser ces informations-là.
Ok. There is an acute problem in Cameroon. Cameroonians are crying. Seemingly, we've not seen a political leader, party, take up this as a key issue, or some local representatives, knowing that this is the basic, most important document for the citizens. Nobody seems to care. The population has been abandoned to themselves.
Sure, Mr. Liu, today there is something that I wrote on my Facebook page. I talked about the fact that we have a government that is reactive and proactive, okay? It took Cameroonians to take the social media and even on newspapers as well as TV like my Media Prime for Martin Bargangile to talk like he did today. I believe that the aspect of ID card is something that is not today. It's an old story.
We have discussed that at least twice on this platform.
So many times, that's what I'm saying. That's why I'm also applauding my Media Prime. But it needed to go beyond for the man in charge of national security, Martin Bargangele, to come up today and give us so many points that he has given today. But now, the issue that you've asked me, Mr. Liu, is the fact that what stops our parliamentarians and politicians from coming into it? We should be able to say here that an ID card is a prerequisite for you to get a voter's card.
Mm-hmm.
That is what makes you to vote. Now, and a majority of our parliamentarians depend on the votes of their compatriots. It means that for you to vote, you need an elections card. And for you to have one, you need an ID card. Now, if you cannot fight for your citizens, you cannot fight for those to ensure that they have their ID cards. Because till now, we've not had any politician, like you've said, we've not had any parliamentarian come out and say, okay, my people are suffering from an issue of ID card. They've all stayed quiet. And I feel that it is something that Cameroonians are already getting used to. Mr. Atema said something that Cameroonians are beginning to cultivate this spirit to work on their own. Cameroonians are beginning to get used to the fact that we voted for him to be a parliamentarian. Let him work on his own, and we're going to work on our own. Because we're expecting that now parliamentarians should have raised this issue of ID card. An ID card is...
ID card and passport. Cameroonians are crying every day.
Sure, Mr. Leo, even on the issue of passport, I believe that Martin Bargangele talked about the fact that The new computerized system that has been put in place is going to take just 48 hours for a Cameroonian to get an ID card.
A new company.
And that they are soliciting that the president should permit that they should look for another company that will partner with them in the production of all this. So when you look at the whole thing, it's an issue of a whole system. It's something that is a whole process. We know how these things are done. If you want your ID card in less than no time, go to Yaoundé. It will not take you a week. There are people who get their passports in a week, in 2 weeks, in 1 month. There are those who get even after 2 years. Because when you get to Yaoundé, there is generally these guys that they call the middlemen. You need to see them. They go see this person, they see this person, which I believe it should not be the case. A lady left America in a seminar I attended, and the lady said, all through her life, all the countries she has traveled in apparently all African countries. Cameroon is the only country that she discovered that it is very cumbersome for you to get passports and for you to travel. And she, at the end, when she acquired it, she was like, what is really wrong? What disturbs? Because, Mr. Liu, if you look at all this process of ID card, if you were to go where they produce these ID cards and actually see what is, or maybe you want to find out what is preventing the company in charge from giving Cameroonians their ID cards, say a week or two after, you will not actually see. But it is maybe something like a system whereby somebody somewhere needs to delay the production of ID cards so that maybe the police officer who is down there gets his own small gumbo by the street. Because I do not understand why a basic document, which is an ID card, which is a necessity for every Cameroonian, I think that maybe they should be, and that they say the government should be thinking of how to ensure that once you get of the age, which is of acquiring an ID card, which I'm sure is 18, once you get of that age of acquiring an ID card, it should even be made compulsory, so much such that the government even shares. Mr. Tem raised the point which I want to tie with them. MTN, once your SIM card is going to expire, you had registered a SIM card and maybe it's going to get out of network, say tomorrow. MTN reminds you 1 week before, 3 days before, 4 days, 2 days. And even the day that your SIM card is going to go out of network, there is this constant information. What stops the Cameroon government? There is an entire corps in the police force that is in charge only with the production of ID cards. What stops the government to ensure that Cameroonians are informed? You go to do your ID card and they tell you, okay, Mr. Kumlinat, you've done it today. Today is the 8th. You've done it today, the 8th of January 2021. Maybe say in 3 months. Before the 3 months, they should inform you. Even with travel agencies here in town, Mr. Liu, when you send a parcel to somebody from Douala, say to Yaoundé or to Boya, the travel company, what they do is, as I sent to Mr. Atemabako, already here they start informing him that you are waiting for this parcel, wait for this person, I'll send you this. So I believe that at the level of ID cards in Cameroon, there is this element, I don't know whether to call it neglect, the communication strategy at the level of ID cards in Cameroon needs to be beefed up, because the communication put in place by the government is not
there. ID cards are charged, the responsibility to produce ID cards for Cameroonians is given to a corps in Cameroon. The corps in charge of national security, they are not delivering. Should the government just keep watching and allow them to tell Cameroonians the manner with which the press conference was given, I read through it, it's more of a political document. Should the government not get to the level of sanctioning? How do we understand this? It means that they say, okay, you are in charge of providing potable water to Cameroonians. You do as you please, and nobody talks. You're in charge of producing electricity to provide to Cameroonians. You do as you wish. Nobody says anything.
Mitalio, it's just that the regime or the CPDM is very self-centered.
No, but it's the police and the government. It's not the party here.
Mr. Liu, I know what I'm talking about. You will not, Mr. Kum or Mr. Liu, they are the same person. So it doesn't matter which sector of the government I'm referring to. Mm-hmm. You see, Cameroonians don't have the spirit of solving problems. They are problem lovers. They love problems. Because when a problem exists, that is when they now create opportunities to do what? To extort
and to make some other opportunity out of that problem and not solving the problem, but taking advantage of that problem and failing to understand that they are penalizing and punishing other Cameroonians, because you are dealing here with Cameroonians. And that is why I always said that whatever we do at the end of the day in this country, we should do it in the sense of winning. That is all of us winning together and not you taking advantage of another person. For example, I still go back again to mention of MTN. The MTN now has a new service whereby your ID card is identified with your SIM. So that means that when your ID card expires, they cut off your line.
Sure.
You have to go renew your ID card and you go reestablish back your line. So that means that the security system for ID card is already effective. We can see already signed from MTN. So if the government is not delivering, it means that it is the government's problem. Because already at the level of MTN, it's very effective, Mr. Liu. Once your ID card expires, your network gets automatically, because you are out of network. Your ID card is not valid. So MTN will not allow you use their service because they wanted every user, network user, to be identified at their service with your identification document until they began sending their servicemen from door to door to register individuals that are under that network. Is that not so? They will even call you on phone and say, this number you are using has not yet been identified. We don't know who is using this number. Mr. Liu, all this thing is to build security, whereby when there's an event, for example, you make a mistake and send money to another number, MTN should know the individual and the name and the position of that individual to whom you have sent that money to. I don't know if you are getting my point. So that means that at the level of the networks, when the government pressurized them to identify all their citizens, when security issue became a raising concern in Cameroon, all networks began registering all their users, and thus it still happened till today. So the question hereby is that if local networks, small businesses that are under the government, paying taxes to the government, and managing their own sector very well and effectively very well, what now stops the government from also mobilizing its own network, making sure that if your ID card was expired, whether you come 10 years and you brought a different name, they should know that this was a name you used before, because it's already in the system.
And just produce it back.
Even verify from you why you were going to change your name, because the same individual, the fingerprints are still the same. So these are the kind of things that I'm saying that, Mr. Liu, things like this happen for political reasons. Because from there you can build a census, especially when it comes to area of elections. Because like he rightly said, you will not vote if you don't have a voter's card. You can't have a voter's card if you don't have an ID card. So from there, the government can already manage and put a lot of things to their own advantage. Now, the question here is that all those other 350 opposition parties who also claim to be saviors, why could they not raise up this issue and say, why are citizens not giving ID cards after they have applied to own an ID card? Because when we go in for election, we don't get the population. I don't know if you understand me. We don't get the number of voters that we would have gotten if every Cameroonian had their identification document. So at the end of the day, I come back to say that it's a political interest and it's in the advantage of the government. And these are the kind of things that I kept saying, that CPDM has not been winning. Even for the Cameroonians, it has not been winning. And CPM needs to do a lot. And the government in place needs to do a lot. And the department for the ID card needs to do a lot. Every department that is in the government, like I still say, should be accountable to the people. They should be able to deliver. And if they don't deliver, they need to be accountable for. You cannot just live as if it's your father's house. You cannot be in the government and you think that because you are in the government, you own all power. Like I kept saying, they don't have monopoly over power. So change can come from any angle. Equally, it can still come from the masses. Like the youth in Cameroon makes the majority. So if Cameroonians build the sense of unism and learn to work together, learn to work as one, with such this kind of thing, Mr. Liu, it will not happen in Cameroon. If Cameroonians decide today and say, we are going to build this country, if the government wants to go left, they say, no, you will not go like this. This is how you are supposed to go. So there are certain disciplines whereby the people themselves can take, and their leaders will sit upright.
Okay.
Like I kept saying, Mr. Liu, If 20 million or 15 million or 10 million Cameroonians rise up today, the government will come straight like a ruler. So it takes also the responsibility of the citizens in this country. So we should not only blame the government, this all of us that have to be blamed.
We have talked about a political, why politicians are quiet. A political leader is reacting. Prince Ekosso, the national president of the USDP, is reacting from Yaoundé. You will react to what he has to say. He says, good evening to you all on the panel concerning the issue of ID card, passports and other documents in Cameroon. It is not like the government does not know what to do. USDP has written a number of proposals to the regime so as to solve this dilemma to no avail. From our view, three things are the cause of for this dilemma. One, corruption is an option for the regime functioning. Cameroonians should know that the regime has endorsed corruption in such a way that if you fight against it, you become a scapegoat. Two, over-centralization. Whenever you take a vivid look at how and why Mr. Paul Biya has been able to maintain its grip on Cameroonians, is because of over-centralization. Everything rises and falls around Mr. Paul Biya. How do you imagine that Cameroonians leave Kolofata to Yaoundé to follow up on retirement benefits and the processing of other documents? The ID card process in Cameroon is not biometric, as some are claiming. As a matter of fact, from your birth certificate, every information should be computerized biometrically and digital. In that way, it becomes very easy to get your ID card or driving license or other documents. So one of your panelists should not be accusing opposition parties because it doesn't know what the USDP is doing.
Il faut qu'on se dise un certain nombre de choses quand même. Mm-hmm. Le gouvernement, à travers la délégation générale à la Sûreté nationale,
oui,
a pris ses responsabilités et a reconnu un certain nombre de dysfonctionnements, mais qui sont liés au fait que, à terme, il faudrait que nous puissions avoir des cartes nationales d'identité sécurisées et ultra sécurisées, y compris des passeports sécurisés. Bon, maintenant, dans le cadre de cette mise en place, il y a eu un certain nombre de dysfonctionnements et de retards techniques. Mais je vais vous dire quelque chose, monsieur Léo. Vous allez remarquer que bon nombre de ceux qui sont en train de réclamer la carte nationale d'identité, ils n'ont pas tous les mêmes problèmes. Si on arrive à commencer à vouloir identifier cas par cas, vous allez voir qu'ils n'ont pas le même problème. Parmi ceux qui sont, par exemple, en train de dire « ma carte n'est pas sortie et tout », il n'a pas mis pied au commissariat peut-être depuis 2-3 mois. Comme il avait fait peut-être un tour une fois, et peut-être qu'on a reconduit en termes de prolongement, il s'est dit « ah ben, il n'y a plus rien ». Pourtant, la carte est arrivée peut-être le lendemain ou bien juste une semaine plus tard. Ça fait partie des 245 000 cartes qui sont établies et qui sont en souffrance aujourd'hui. Lorsque on nous dit que si vous voulez, par exemple, importer de la marchandise à l'étranger, vous connaissez un certain nombre de facteurs liés au transport, liés au dédouanement et ainsi de suite. Donc, lorsque vous connaissez également la date d'expiration, de péremption également de votre carte nationale d'identité, vous prenez un certain nombre de dispositions un peu plus tôt. Et ça peut vous permettre, mais cela ne voudrait pas dédouaner ceux qui doivent l'établir, parce qu'en fait, l'idée est ici que je pense avec cette sortie de la délégation générale à la sûreté nationale, nous sommes confiants pour l'avenir en nous disant que nous allons avoir des cartes nationales d'identité qui sont déjà informatisées, mais ultra sécurisées et qui seront disponibles un peu plus à temps. Lorsqu'on nous dit que il n'y a pas eu de facilité, le gouvernement a eu à alerter un certain nombre de partenaires qui sont liés avec l'utilisation des cartes nationales d'identité telles que les entreprises de la téléphonie mobile, M. Ebako. On nous a dit également ici que la carte nationale d'identité est toujours valable jusqu'à son expiration. On nous a dit également que les récépissés sont également valables jusqu'à ce qu'on puisse vous délivrer l'original. Donc, tous ces éléments-là sont pris en compte pour qu'il y ait continuité du service public, pour qu'il n'y ait pas goulot d'étranglement. Vous n'allez pas dire que c'est parce que certains n'ont pas encore retiré leur carte nationale d'identité que le fichier électorale en termes de nombre d'inscrits n'évolue pas. Je ne sais pas, vous voulez qu'il arrive à combien? 10 000, 20 000, 15 000 inscrits?
Pourquoi il y a des fois où le gouvernement décide que c'est free, non? Mm-hmm. We saw it during a short 2011 oui. elections.
They said it was free. Jusque-là, les gens n'ont pas établi la carte. Vous vous souvenez, le président de la République avait même prolongé la date, hein, parce qu'il n'y avait même pas bousculé dans les commissariats. Et là, c'était gratuit.
Oui, mais bon. Pourquoi ne pas laisser ça gratuit maintenant?
Jusqu'à la fin.
Mais le problème aussi qui se pose, c'est que c'est ce même gouvernement qui est en train de gérer les défis d'ordre sécuritaire. C'est un coup. C'est ce même gouvernement qui est en train de gérer la pandémie du COVID-19. C'est un coup. C'est ce gouvernement qui est en train de préparer la relance de notre économie. C'est un coup. C'est ce gouvernement qui connaît le ralentissement de l'économie mondiale.
Mais est-ce que vous reconnaissez quand même que c'est aussi parce que tout est fait à Yaoundé, donc c'est aussi beaucoup de boulot, non?
Non, la concentration n'est pas un problème tant qu'on arrive à obtenir ce qu'on veut.
Non, c'est-à-dire en réalité... Non, les gens sont en train de pleurer.
Oui, ben, on nous dit en réalité que le problème n'est pas forcément parce que on parle de concentration.
On parle de
le problème est beaucoup plus sur la technicité et sur la sécurisation du fichier et aussi maintenant, et aussi sur les doubles, triples identifications.
Monsieur Youth, we are in the 21st century. Mm-hmm. You are talking about technicalities of producing ID cards. In the 21st century, should a foreign company be producing ID cards for Cameroonians? And you are talking about security. It means that this foreign company that surely is from France, they have all of our information that they give to their country. So what security are we talking about?
Pour l'instant, je ne sais pas si vous avez lu le contrat ou le protocole d'accord entre le partenaire de la délégation générale à la sûreté nationale pour que nous puissions savoir quelles sont les dispositions. N'oubliez pas aussi que il ne sera jamais rendu public. Les informations de sécurisation de ce fichier. Je suis convaincu et je vous mettrai à défi que vous, comme moi, oui. Nous ne savons pas exactement quelle est la sécurisation réelle de ce fichier. Alors, bon, peut-être que sur les plateaux, nous allons nous mettre à pouvoir débattre et épiloguer, mais jusqu'à preuve de contraire, on n'a pas encore vu un cas qui démontre que les informations du Cameroun se sont retrouvées partout et n'importe comment. Donc, il n'y a pas encore de faille. Donc, conclusion, ça voudrait dire que dans le cadre du contrat de partenariat entre le gouvernement et son partenaire, public et privé, il y a eu un certain nombre de dispositions. Et c'est pour cela que la délégation générale à la sécurité nationale, de par la conférence de presse d'aujourd'hui, nous démontre à juste titre que le fichier de la carte nationale d'identité et celui du passeport est bel et bien sécurisé.
Good evening, Mr. Liu and the guests in the studio. Thanks for this pertinent topic of ID card, which has been a thorn in the flesh of most Cameroonians. It is a result of incompetence and corruption at the identification centers, which has given room to big businesses, to those at checkpoints. Ambe Manuel, writing from Baumba Foot Subdivision. Good evening to you, Ambe. This one says, hello, good evening to you all. The question is, why is an ID done only in Yaoundé? Why is it not done in every region? Do you know how many Cameroonians had died on the road to Yaoundé from all the regions because of ID? May God help Cameroon. Good evening to you people. This problem of ID is too much. My husband did his ID since 12 years ago, and whenever he went to look for, they would say it has not come. They have extended it up to the paper is full, and they have added another paper. I'm really confused with this problem of ID in Cameroon. Clara is writing from Kumba. Good evening to you. Lane Mathias says, dear customers, your ID card would expire in 50 days. Kindly remember to renew the ID card and update your identification at the nearest MTN shop center, MTN Care. Question, can this very system send a message informing us when this ID card is ready at the centers where you establish it? Okay, yeah, if MTN can do it, why can't the Cameroon government not do it? Good evening, Mr. Liu. Your panelists on that platform is learning on inconsistency in order of names as reason why Cameroonians make IDs and never have them. May I know why ID cards be given expiry dates in the first place? Second, he says close to 300,000 ID cards are lying abandoned and in identification centers. What has happened with the phone numbers collected during the establishing of the document when it finally is out? People go to check ID cards every day to no avail, yet their ID cards left there. To whom do they belong? Livinus is writing from Bamenda. Good evening, Mr. Liu and the panelists. Thanks very much for the topic. My wife made hers and 2 years there was no sign until we had to pay 50,000 francs before it came, can showing 2 years backward. Okay. Hi, Mr. Kum. This issue of ID card is a big problem. 80% of the errors on the card is done by the police officers. Most of them have first culivers and can, okay. Ngiando from Mankon Town in Bamenda. Good evening to you, Ngiando. Good evening, Mr. Liu, and to all in the panel. The government is killing us with ID card because our phone numbers are being taken. When doing our ID, communication companies send us message. Why can't they do it with ID cards? Good evening, my son. My son's ID card renewed 3 times after 1 year. Now it has been renewed again now for 1 year. And at the University of Boya, too soon, graduate without national ID. I'm tired and the ID card issue. Please, we need urgent measures like that of the hemodialysis center in Bamenda, please. I think that what the man of CPDM is saying about disturbed information is not true, because info is taken from one's old ID card by the police themselves. You don't give information to be fed into your ID card. Good evening, sir. A beautiful program. We like to listen on English. Okay, thank you very much. Good evening, Mr. Kum and panel. I'm Dolu Lilian, writing from Idinau. This issue of ID card is just as a result of lack of decentralization in Cameroon. It's a total scam right now for people to be spending their hard-earned money all the time just to be receiving receipts all the time with the same information given as that of the last ID card. It's so frustrating. Delos is writing from Kumba. Good evening to you, Delos. Good evening to the crew. May the Almighty bless all of you and anoint you with more wisdom to enable a better execution of your Republican duties. Thank you very much. Dr. Busi Ennis, writing from Boya, says, I don't accept the fact that the issuing of ID card is a partisan issue. What we need is decentralized, computerized system of database to monitor the situation and prints at the policies being made. Dr. Busi Ennis Aboya. Now, how somebody is raising the issue of ID card expires in 5 years, is it that the person is going to transform to something else, or what is the rationale behind it?
Those are some of the many questions we've always asked, and some of us Many times, some of us who are a bit enlightened, we've always had problems with uniform officers. Because, Mr. Liu, your name is Kum Leonard. You've made an ID card. You are a Cameroonian. The issue is you never transform from who you are to be somebody else. Now, how does an ID card expire? That's the first question you ask yourself. I've had situations, Mr. Liu, where people travel, show an ID card that expired only yesterday. I mean, a day, the ID card is 1 day old. And the uniform officer, because we are living in a country where once you give your ID card to a police officer, many a time they don't even look at the face. What they are looking at, the 10 behind, their focus is look at the expiring date. That's their major focus. They don't want to even compare the face, the name, and the person. They want to know whether your ID card has expired or is expiring anytime soon. And if it is to expire maybe in 2 or 3 days, they are very careful to tell you, go on. But now if it has expired just for a day, they tell you, come down of the car. And given that we're in Cameroon, you're bound to give something to them. I think that if we are using the microphone today, it's because we believe that so many opinion leaders are listening, like even my very good friend, youth who is listening, and maybe those of his party are also listening. I believe that an ID card, first of all, should not expire. Why should an ID card expire? Once you do an ID card, you're already a citizen of that country. And there should be no need of talking about an ID card expiring. Why should it, first of all, expire? You do your ID card at the age of 18, it should take you till maybe you're not longer there. Because the same information is the same, your birth certificate is the same, you're the same Cameroonian, your name has not changed, and it's almost the same. Why should an ID card expire? And I believe that, Ms. Aliu, that's another very good point that you're raising, that maybe should be set as an agenda, so much so that those who are concerned, the opinion leaders are going to hear and see how they can come, really do something about it. Because ID cards, like we were saying this evening, remain very, very important in the lives of every Cameroonian. And the fact that they do expire is just a way of enriching our uniform officers who are out there. And if ID cards were not expiring, it's another way of reducing what uniform officers get daily from those who travel. A uniform officer will come and ask you, why are you not putting on the face mask, whereas he is not even putting it on. Comes and tells you, show your ID card, without him showing his own ID card. Because the Lord makes it and it's very clear that for a uniform officer to ask you for your identification papers, he's also supposed to present his own, which should also be his. But that is not the case in our country. I believe in our country, Cameroon, the fear of the police is the beginning of wisdom.
Okay. But how do we reconcile these difficulties with understanding of the police officers who want the documents that are difficult to come by? They will hardly understand that you have gone and gone and gone to their colleagues and the ID cards are not there.
Mr. Liu, that is why I said that, you see, we have developed the habit of finding faults where there is no fault and leaving the areas where there are faults and they don't complain about
it. You have an ID card that has expired, that expired last week.
He has tomorrow.
He has every information.
That expires yesterday.
He has every information that can identify you.
That is what I'm saying.
Down, yes.
That is exactly why I'm saying that. You are finding fault where there is no fault. I don't know if you try to get the logic.
Because the ID card is...
There is no fault there because the person who gave you the expiration date should know before even you when your ID card should expire, because it's a department that issued the ID card to you and said the ID card is going to last, for example, for 10 years. So that means that in their database, it should already tell them every month those whose ID card are going to expire in 2-3 months' time, so that they should alert them beforehand. So this gives room now for other officers who are on ground to take advantage, as though the citizens have defaulted, when it's not a crime, because it is the state that issues the ID card. Therefore means that the security officers who are in control, either at the road or at any other place, checking for ID cards and identification as people are moving from one place to another, should understand that ID cards are not being printed in cyber cafes or documentation rooms. They are official documents and it has a special format which every officer should identify that this is a state issued document to this individual. So by the time the officer is finding fault there and not finding fault why your ID card was not you were not informed by the government or by the state or the bureau of the agency that issued ID card that your ID card was going to expire, they should have turned and asked that department that, but why is this person's ID card expired? Why did you not call him to let him know? So you realize that you leave the area where the blame is, and then you fall where there is no fault. That is, you are trying to find fault where there is no fault. Mm-hmm. So this is the attitude of Cameroonians, and that's why I kept insisting that whenever a crisis shows up like the war,
Everybody wants to make money out of it, and nobody wants to solve the problem because of interest. And these are the issues where the country cannot excel because the citizens themselves, including the government, are in complicity of corruption. It means that the citizens are helping the government to be more corrupted equally as the government. So there is a blame to be placed on every Cameroonian and not only the government, because we do encourage corruption. I have seen in several cases whereby the question I keep asking myself is that why do people not complain? A good example again I will still give is still the roads we have in Cameroon, especially the one in Douala, that horse traffic so terribly, and nobody complains, but yet you find officers that are there disturbing car owners, taking money from them, finding faults where there is no fault. That is the mentality where we are, and the areas where we need to blame, we don't blame. So we protect criminals and then we condemn innocent people. That is the state in which we are. So take for example, like I said before, before your ID card should expire, you should not go to the bureau and say you want to renew your ID card. They should have called you that your ID card is going to expire. Renew your ID card within this period.
But my question still stands here.
Yes.
Monsieur, you have an ID card.
Mm-hmm.
It is expired last week.
Yes.
You cannot travel with it.
Mm-hmm.
What is the essence of an ID card? Is to identify you.
The essence of an ID card, that is a very good question. The essence of an ID card, it goes on two ways, Mr. Liu, mm-hmm. is to identify that holder, mm-hmm. one. Two is to make sure that in case the person is diseased, you understand, and you don't come back for renewal, they can assume that this person no longer lives.
Yeah.
But that is why now, in the process of you establishing an ID card, there are information that you give. Whereby if for a week or a month you don't come, it's in the place of the government to verify that individual status, whether the person is of late or the person is still current. But however, if the person is still living and you have an ID card which already expired, it's not an offense. You should only be told or reminded to renew for renewal. But like I still said that, people will take advantage of it as if it is a fault. You tell me now, Mr. Liu, that your ID card, my ID card, how many years I cannot even remember. It looks very old, Mr. Liu. I should expect the government, the state of the issuing of ID card should have called me to come and obtain the new one. With MTN, I give you another example, where if you are living from 3G, when they were living from 3G to 4G, they call their clients and say, come and upgrade, because the system is upgrading. And so every other person that was functioning with the former system, they tell you, no, come, this one is no longer up to date. We now give you what is up to date. So that is that flexibility and dynamism that we are not getting from the side of the government. So it is not an offense that somebody's ID card is expired for 6 days and now he's been interrupted by an officer who understands the system in Cameroon.
Monsieur Youth,
Monsieur Ibako donne des idées de relance pour que lorsque la carte est en train d'expirer, qu'on vous alerte et tout. Je ne sais pas s'il a mesuré aussi le coût, hein. Parce qu'en réalité, nous sommes sous l'ère où on est en train de parler des coupes budgétaires.
Le président de la République a souhaité bonne année et à tout le monde. Non? Tu as reçu, non?
Oui, le président de la République a souhaité bonne année à tout le monde.
Oui, mais c'est ça, non?
Mais maintenant, ici, le système des cadres nationaux d'identité,
oui.
Ce n'est pas une fois l'an. Parce qu'en réalité, les cadres nationaux d'identité n'expirent pas au même moment.
Oui.
Donc, ça voudrait dire que c'est un système permanent. Alors, avec... si vous partez sur une base de 20 millions de cadres nationaux d'identité, dans le cadre de la base de données à gérer, avec un coût moyen entre 9 et 10 francs.
20 millions ?
20 millions de cadres nationaux d'identité.
Ah oui.
Parce que même un enfant, on établit un cadre nationaux d'identité. Hein. Si vous voulez voyager avec votre enfant de plus de 6 mois, vous allez établir le passeport.
Oui.
Donc, ça veut dire qu'il peut aussi avoir la cadre nationaux d'identité. Donc, si on dit que les Camerounais, c'est 22 millions... le Camerounais, ça veut dire que c'est une base de données possible de 22 millions. Alors, si vous prenez une moyenne de 9 à 10 francs le SMS, vous êtes là à 200 millions lorsque vous envoyez une fois. Et puis maintenant, si c'est répétitif, vous allez voir. Et nous, les Camerounais, nous sommes très forts. Nous serons les premiers à dire quelle est cette affaire de l'argent qui va à la délégation générale de la Société nationale qui s'appelle au niveau des SMS. MTN le fait à travers son réseau.
Camtel.
MTN le fait à travers son réseau. Camtel le fait aussi à travers son... Camtel, ses services sont payants. S'il y a des garçons générales à la société nationale, voulaient avoir accès aux services de Camtel, ils payent la facture. Et ça doit être budgétisé. Donc, nous avons également... la délégation générale de la société nationale a mis un numéro vert, 1550, pour pouvoir consulter la situation de disponibilité de l'établissement de la carte nationale d'identité.
Vous appelez Yaoundé ou...
Non, vous tapez la 1550, tout simplement, par SMS et tout, vous avez la situation. C'est très facile pour vous-même.
C'est
opérationnel.
Oui, vous payez l'argent?
Non, c'est un numéro vert, gratuit. 1550. Mm-hmm. C'est comme par exemple, vous pouvez appeler le 1500 pour appeler la police et 1500 pour appeler la gendarmerie. C'est un numéro vert. Comme vous pouvez appeler le 118. Le 118.
Et tous les centres ont ça?
Non, dit que, je vous dis que c'est des éléments pour pouvoir faciliter.
Quand vous appelez là, vous appelez que c'est dans
dès que vous tapez c'est cette information, vous tapez le numéro de votre carte nationale d'identité ou bien le numéro du récépissé pour savoir à quel niveau se situe donc votre carte nationale d'identité, l'information
ça va faire le travail.
Bon, maintenant, on est en train d'évoluer sur cette base-là. C'est la base aussi de la dématérialisation. C'est la base également de la facilitation pour ne pas encombrer par une demande au niveau des commissariats. Prenons les habitudes du digital. C'est ce qui est fait aujourd'hui. Mais et également, quand on nous ramène, M. Ebako nous ramène l'idée de la corruption encore, tout le monde sait, a priori naturellement maintenant, que l'argent qui est pris au niveau du point d'identification, c'est le prix de la photo et le prix du temple. C'est tout. La photo, c'est 2000. Enfin, c'est 1800. Et l'autre, 1000 francs pour le timbre, voilà le coût. Les autres papiers ne relèvent pas du point d'identification. C'est vous qui apportez les autres papiers des autres services administratifs. Donc, où est la corruption à ce niveau? Maintenant, est-ce que, si vous me dites par exemple que lorsque votre carte nationale d'identité est établie et disponible, on va vous demander les sous au retrait. Est-ce que c'est le cas? Ce n'est pas le cas. Donc, ne faisons pas l'amalgame. Mais maintenant, il y a des situations parmi nos concitoyens. Je vous prends un exemple. Une dame, elle était célibataire par exemple. Elle établit sa carte nationale d'identité à son nom de jeune fille. Maintenant, elle se marie, elle veut utiliser le nom de son mari. Mais elle n'apporte pas toute la documentation nécessaire, mais en fait, c'est ce nom-là qu'elle est en train d'utiliser dans la vie civile, partout. Cette dame, en fait, est en double identité déjà. Voilà les questions et les problèmes. Et après, maintenant, lorsque... on va vouloir, elle va vouloir établir la carte nationale d'identité, sans toutefois démontrer que le nom de son époux qu'elle a ajouté et puis son ancien nom de jeune fille, c'est toujours la même personne. Il y a blocage.
Non, c'est facile de trouver parce que you have the fingerprint, Mr. Liu.
C'est-à-dire que la machine reconnaît et établit qu'il y a double identité. Et là, maintenant, la machine, et là, la machine vous dit ceci, et le communiqué de presse d'aujourd'hui dit qu'il se refait à la première identification.
Mm-hmm. Oui, mais maintenant, la première identification...
La première identification ne correspond pas, ne satisfait pas. Concitoyen a commencé à utiliser le nom, par exemple, de son époux.
Mais pourquoi ne pas l'appeler
Pourquoi ne pas aussi produire les papiers nécessaires à l'établissement et attendre que quand ça va bloquer, et en réalité, si ça ne bloquait pas, il devait avoir problème. Ça, c'est des preuves qui montrent que le système est en train de fonctionner. C'est des preuves qui montrent qu'on commence à être dans des difficultés à avoir une double identité au Cameroun.
Monsieur Youth, oui. vous simplifiez tout ce que les gens décrivent là-dehors?
Non.
Ces gens-là ont tort?
Non. On n'a pas dit qu'ils ont tort. La preuve en est. On a commencé notre propos en disant que la délégation générale de la société nationale reconnaît que la prise en main de la technologie, la sécurisation du fichier et tout ont créé des boulots d'étranglement et des retards. Ils l'ont dit. On n'est pas en train de dire que certains n'ont pas leur cadre de solidarité.
When this press conference is convened today to explain the situation and even announcing the possible creation of another pool out there in the north region, we should also remember that the same official said that by January, passports are going to be available within 24 hours or 48 hours. So this is already January. So announcing that Garwa is going to start producing ID cards is also another thing. But we'll be signing because the signature of CB, his signature.
Non, c'est une organisation interne. C'est juste une capacité de production. Donc, augmenter la capacité de production. Passer de 10 000 à 15 000.
Oui, mais c'est lui qui va toujours signer. Non? Ok, oui, on va voir sa signature là-bas.
Tout, ils ont pris leur disposition. Mm. Le problème ici, c'est la disponibilité de la carte.
Ok. Do we have to wait for Cameroonians to cry, to say, come up with a launch a campaign before we are telling them that, okay, some people want to use this for political reasons? When you read that they communicate, that some people are trying to blow the situation out of proportion. Are things really under control and that other some persons are exaggerating?
No, Mr. Liu, like you said before now, when I went through the communique from Mathemba Al-Gangele, it was more of a retaliation than informative because I did not see him informing Cameroonians. I rather saw him reacting to what so many persons have been complaining. And it is but normal with the current regime that the regime is reactive than proactive. ID cards, if you're in charge of national security, Cameroonians do not need to go that far to cry that they don't have their ID cards before you come up with a statement and you say that more than 245,000 ID cards are pending collection. When you go to police stations and you see the number of Cameroonians who go there every day to check for their ID cards, if you say ID cards are pending collection, the question you ask, I want to ask myself is, where are they? Are they in Yaoundé where they are being produced or they have been sent to the different places or the different police areas where these people need to collect? I doubt if that is the case. Because many Cameroonians, Mr. Liu, if you've traveled in this country, in Cameroon, without an ID card, then you will not stay for a day without going every day to a police post to check whether your ID card has come. It means that when I went through the communique, I just felt that he was normally struggling to play the game that every politician is struggling to play, because Cameroonians have been harassed and they have been harassed every day because of identification papers. And it was been normal for Cameroonians to come out and say, okay, no, we think that an ID card should not be something that should cost much money for people to get. But he came out as most of the ministers, instead of informing Cameroonians, was retaliating. Because when you read the three-page document that I took time to read through, when you read the three-page document from the Delegate of National Security, it is only struggling to defend. It's more of defensive. It's defending why Cameroonians are unable to get their ID card when it's not time. He's explaining that Cameroonians, their ID cards are there. A majority do not go to collect. Are these ID cards in Yaoundé or they have gone, for instance, to Suzawe for those who have made the ID cards? In Menjum, for instance, those who have made the ID cards. There is no way 245,000 ID cards will be in different police stations and Cameroonians have not gone to collect. It goes to tell you that it was more of defending a ministry than normally explaining to Cameroonians, short and simple, we have this problem, we are struggling to sort it out, and once the problem is sorted out, your problems will be solved.
Yeah, but it's been dragging on for years now, eh?
Sure, it's been dragging on for years now, but we are still saying that, Mr. Liu, that the problem of ID card is something that I consider, to me, is, to an extent, trivial. It's not something that we needed to be coming over and over it, because an ID card costs nothing. There is something I've said before now that when you go to the university, or even elections card, it's the same as the ID card. Mm-hmm. Look at the card that they give us in the university. As you enter the film, it's kakak, it comes out, they give you, that doesn't take a day. They give you the same thing. Why should an ID card take almost a year? Why should Cameroonians need to keep stamping their ID cards? And worse still, If Prince has a problem and is in the police station, Mr. Liu cannot visit him because he doesn't have an ID card. It means that even those who do the ID card know fully well that you have an ID card, but it has expired, and they will not want to understand that it is because of their own same colleagues that you're not having the ID card. Yeah. I feel that, Mr. Liu, that the minister has spoken. We look forward that in the days ahead, like you've said, it's not the first time he's speaking. We look forward that in the days ahead, something better is going to be done, because the situation about ID cards out there is really very, very precarious.
Okay. Good evening, Mr. Liu. As concerns frequent attacks on the forces of defense and security in the Northwest and Southwest regions, it is not surprising at all. Since the separatists or terrorists are fighting a guerrilla warfare, I'm sure they have perfected the guerrilla tactics, which are, okay, Tabe Bisong is writing from Muya and in Boya. Clinton, writing from Gomgam, it's 2 years now I haven't received my ID card. Oops. Okay. Good evening, Mr. Liu. Please, if someone has changed occupation like a driver to a teacher, is it a crime to change your new ID card? Yeah, you can do that. Good evening, Mr. Liu, and Happy New Year to you all in the studio. The man in the suit is not giving tangible reasons by telling us that people change their names during identification. Emmanuel, writing from Gusu in Yaoundé. Good evening, Mr. Liu. You are leading a good program. As usual, this issue of ID card is a very pertinent one. Bona fide Cameroonians are being extorted money for crimes committed by the government. Surprisingly, this is done by the same government. Funge is writing from where? Good evening, Mr. Liu. If the service concern on ID card production can copy the way banks do ATM card, if they are customers, it's going to be the best. ATM cards automatically updated immediately it expires. If this is done, okay. Jang is writing from Manfi. Good evening to the panel. Very good topic. We are tight. I lost my ID card. I paid for attestation of loss, but a police officer hold me and said he will lock me up for that. He only wants me to give him 1,000 francs, but I didn't give him. Ernest, writing from Kumba. Good evening, Ernest. Si l'identification MTN ou Orange se fait avec votre carte nationale, alors quand votre carte périmée, MTN vous informe. I don't know what you are saying, but I'm sure you are trying to say what Ebako said earlier on. Good evening, Mr. Liu. Thanks for your programs. It's Mami Lucy from Limbe. The problem is ID card is so funny. The laws we are facing about this ID card is too much. They will ask you to 1,000 francs will be asked before collecting your ID if it happens to have original card, okay? Good evening, Mr. Liu and your team. I don't see any reason why my ID card will expire, and upon renewal, I'm being asked to do a nationality again, of which I have an ID and I'm a Cameroonian, and also 3 months for ID card receipt is too small. It's a year already that I've gone without an ID card. Foba Roland, writing from Bamenda. Ashu from Boya says, Mr. Liu, good evening. Love the topic for today. You cannot imagine, Mr. Liu, you make ID card in Boya. It takes 1 year to have it. But with 40,000 francs in Yaoundé Express, they give you in less than 24 hours. Is this not where the problem is? That is, Cameroonians from all 10 regions are waiting for the ID cards. Then those who have money go with the money. If in a day, say 500 people come, that is where priority is.
Mr. Liu, it's a whole network that goes from below to top and top to below. Because if, like he was talking about, it's going to be costly for the government to either text or call. You see, I happen to have had some dealings with Camtel some years ago, and I came to understand that there are individuals in the government and many government officials that are giving a particular SIM card by Camtel, whereby that SIM card every month you got 2.5 million or 3 million, which is renewable automatically. So these good SIM cards are given to officials, and many of them can call any part in the world because the SIM card never runs out. It renews automatically. Now, if the issue is it's going to be costly for the state to inform people, charge us in the cost of making ID card. If you say 2,800, keep it aside. Put it at 10,000 francs and let allow Cameroonians to get their ID cards the following day. So if it's an issue of money, cost us. Put it all in the bill and allow us to make ID cards for 10 or 20,000 francs. Everybody understands that your ID card is 20,000 francs or 10,000 francs. Instead of saying 2,800, when you feel that you are being underpaid to issue ID cards to the citizens. So that is where the main problem is. That is where I feel that we are having a serious problem, because if a policeman takes you 1,000 francs on top of the 2,800 francs, you're already at 3,800 francs. So just tell us that ID card is now 10,000 francs and allow people to obtain their ID card instead of allowing people spending money, traveling, risk up and down, and yet they cannot have dealings because they don't have a valid ID card, or because the receipt they gave them is already torn and already distorted out. You cannot even find another place to put another stamp, and the individual may not still have time to go again to the police station. So, Mr. Liu, I am just mainly saying that the government owns Camtel, and all those other networks are under Camtel. So if the government instructs MTN, Orange, Nextel to inform all the citizens when their cards want to expire, then those networks will gladly do it for the government for free, just to get tax reduction. They will do it for free. So it's not an issue of it's going to be costly for the government. No, only what individuals in the government that are using, they are using networks like Camtel to call. It's more than how 10 francs for pay and a text message to 25 million Cameroonians or 20 million Cameroonians. That's just about is it 200 million or so?
Mm-hmm.
It's about 200 million. But that's what I'm telling you, that they are individuals, about 30 or 20 government officials that are exhausting more than this amount every month. I have had the opportunity of seeing those SIM cards and even have them. They are renewable every month, 3 million francs in the SIM card automatically from Camtel. So this is not an issue of money. So just charge the Cameroonians that an ID card instead of 2,800 now is 5,000 francs, so that we know that when the SMSs are coming, you have already paid for the services. Like you go to a VIP section and you are buying a bottle of beer for 10,000 francs. You see all the waiters are passing there every second. There's AC, there's all of that. So you are paying for all those services. So that's exactly my point. So it's just to tell you that the problem here is that it's a very distorted system, and it is built for corruption, because it's from the head to the toe. Because the officer that are taking 1,000 francs on the road, there's a commission that goes back to the commissioner who sent them on the road. And the commissioner also has another area where he too also sent. So it's a team of network. It's a network. You cannot say that the government does not know these things do operate. There are cameras. There are individuals who are complaining every day of these things happening on the road. But what is the government doing? It's a system. And these are the systems that we need to change as Cameroonians. Instead of us talking as CPDM trying to defend, I've told you, when it comes to the issues in Cameroon, I will have areas, I will blame CPDM, because it has areas where it fails, and those areas we need to fix them.
But CPDM is not a police now.
It's a police.
Mais, par rapport à ce que M. Ebako dit,
oui.
En ce qui concerne les éléments de corruption, le délégué général de la société nationale, M. Mbagangele, il a mis un numéro vert à la disposition de tous les concitoyens que le policier qui est en train de vous amener à poser un acte de corruption, dénoncez-le tout simplement. Et les uns et les autres savent. Ce numéro, ça tombe directement dans le cabinet du délégué général à la Société nationale.
Et
c'est le 1500. C'est connu par tout le monde. Vous avez un problème avec un policier, prenez un certain nombre d'éléments probants, appelez le 1500 et vous verrez que vous aurez les solutions. Je me souviens, j'ai des cas où il y a eu des gens qui se sont fait rembourser immédiatement et avec suspension même de policiers. C'est une réalité. Mais qu'est-ce qui se passe? Nous-mêmes, les concitoyens, nous créons souvent le problème. C'est-à-dire que quoi? C'est nous-mêmes qui... Je vous prends un exemple simple. Vous allez par exemple à une boulangerie. Vous trouvez le rang. Il est assez long. C'est vous qui êtes pressé. C'est vous qui ne voulez pas faire la queue. Vous allez là-bas, vous saluez le gérant ou bien ceci. Pourquoi vous servez avant? C'est cet incivisme-là qui crée les éléments de corruption. Ici, en ce qui concerne la carte nationale d'identité, Monsieur Ebako, le problème ne se pose pas sur le coût d'établissement de la carte nationale d'identité. Parce qu'en réalité, la carte nationale d'identité est bien subventionnée et que le montant qu'on demande est largement suffisant pour l'instant. Rien du tout ne se pose. Mais la technologie de sécurisation de la carte nationale d'identité n'est pas camerounaise. Nous sommes en train de nous approprier cette technologie. Et je vous rappelle également que même les pays développés sont en train de s'arrimer à la nouvelle technologie de sécurisation de la carte nationale d'identité, y compris les passeports. Donc, peut-être que chez nous, ça pique ces quelques mois le temps de voir clair et de mettre en place ces éléments. Mais je peux vous rassurer que moi, j'ai été totalement satisfait de la conférence de presse de la délégation générale de la Société nationale d'aujourd'hui, de cet après-midi, qui m'a rassuré que dans les jours à venir, nous parlons ici d'une validité du cadre national d'identité sur 10 ans. Donc en fait, dès que vous l'avez, c'est encore dans 10 ans que le problème va se poser. Donc si on a fini le temps qu'on a tergiversé, 1 mois, 2 mois, 3 mois, et on a finalement un fichier sécurisé, et aussi avec l'établissement de l'acte de naissance qui commence à être maintenant, qui se rapproche en fait des lieux de naissance, ça voudrait dire que c'est très important, et on nous dit que nous allons avoir un passeport maintenant en 48 heures. Donc, tous ces éléments, ça montre des avancées. Donc, peut-être que dans 2-3 mois, nous n'aurons plus besoin de ce type de débat. Mais nous disons également que ceux qui ont établi les cartes nationales d'identité aillent les retirer. C'est aussi un élément. Nous disons aussi que n'allez pas établir la carte nationale d'identité dans un point d'identification là où vous n'habitez pas. Ou bien là où c'est trop loin, ou bien dans une ville où vous n'y êtes pas. Parce que c'est ça aussi le problème. Ça se pose aussi souvent avec la carte de lecteur. Quelqu'un vend au marché, mais il habite Brazzaville. Et il vend au marché central Lagos. Le moment où on lui demande maintenant d'aller retirer sa carte de lecteur, il n'est pas au marché Lagos. Et il est peut-être inscrit au centre de vote qui est lié au marché Lagos, là. Mais en fait, le jour du vote, il habite Brazzaville. Conclusion, on constate que le taux d'abstention est élevé. Voilà tous ces éléments-là. Donc, inscrivons-nous au point où nous habitons, établissons la carte nationale d'identité au point d'identification où nous pouvons y aller régulièrement et savoir si la carte est déjà sortie. Utilisons les moyens digitaux de vérification de la disponibilité de la carte et de ce qui bloque tel que cela est fait. Appelons le 1500 à chaque fois où nous avons un fonctionnaire de police qui est en train de nous mettre en situation de corruption. Ne soyons pas les corrupteurs et n'encourageons pas la corruption. À partir de ce moment-là, voilà comment nous allons développer notre pays. Parce que on est convaincu que le gouvernement, le président de la République, son excellence, M. Paul Biya, a mis sur pied un nombre d'institutions de lutte contre la corruption. Mais la corruption est d'abord sur le plan mental, sur le plan moral, sur le plan des habitudes, sur le plan de l'éducation et sur le plan de la formation familiale.
Ok, I'll take some few messages before we call it a wrap for today. Good evening, Mr. Liu. I love for your program. This problem of Cameroon searching for national ID card has become a source of income to forces of law and order. We are left at the mercy of corruption with no help. Augustine is writing from Dobo. Okay, not every Cameroonian has the financial might to go for an express passport, so the government should help us. Good evening to you. It did not give your name there. Good evening, Mr. Liu. Concerning this issue of ID cards, I know during elections some political parties go in the quarters, collect information of those that don't have to make ID cards to vote for them. At the end, these people don't know where to go and collect those ID cards. Pascal is writing from Douala. Good evening, Mr. Leo. If the minister is telling the truth, let them publish the names, because most of those cards are the ones used by the government to steal elections. Kimben is writing from Ngembu. Good evening, Mr. Liu. I'm Mohammed, writing from Yaoundé. In Cameroon now, if you succeed in getting your national ID, it's like you have got a visa for Canada or United States of America. Why are we suffering in our country for national ID card? Francis Tambe from Boya. Good evening to you all in the studio. I just believe the identification unit enjoy our suffering, destroying the Western Union banking transactions. I have been 3 years today without an ID card, of which I went but for renewal. I'm presently with the second recipice in the case. I don't know. Okay. Good evening, Mr. Liu. Why is it that when you make an ID card, when it expires, you go to renew, they start asking for court declaration? Why can they not use the expired to renew the old one? Thanks. Lawrence Nuki. Okay, the messages keep pouring in. Should our MPs take a session to address this issue?
Sure, MPs should take a session to really address the issue of ID cards, because ID cards remain very, very important so far as they are coming to office is concerned. Mm. Because I said something that you need an ID card to get a voter's card. It's very true that when elections are very close or elections are near, the MPs have the way they play with those who manage elections, elections governing body, ELECAM, to ensure that even those who don't have ID cards have elections card. Because I've seen persons who don't have ID cards who have voter's card and are such a vote. But normally you're supposed to have an ID card before you have a voter's card. And also I think that those of the opposition political parties should also come into play to see how they can assist, really send a very strong message, because I believe that, like you said, Mr. Leo, this is not the first time that the call of ID cards is coming up. We've listened to a message from Prince Ekoso, and he's of the opposition party, the USDP, and if others of the opposition political parties, as well as MPs, can add their voices and make this, because I believe there is something that Mr. Ibako has said, and I want to buy his idea. If you think that putting ID cards for 2,800 francs, it is too cheap and I will need to wait for 10 years for it to come, put it for 50,000 francs. So much so that Prince knows that the cost for him to get an ID card is 50,000 francs. So much so that once you get it, it's okay. Because, Mr. Liu, if you look at the messages that you have on social media, which I'm sure you cannot read all, there are people who tell you they've not had their ID card since 2002, 2007, 2010. Now imagine somebody maybe living in Bamenda who has not had an ID card from 2010. I want to imagine how the person is living, because you need to live from one checkpoint to the other within the town. You have more than 10 checkpoints. You live on a Sunday. You want to just go out and cash phone. You need to pass a distance that is just 300 francs. You need to pass at least 3 checkposts. So imagine this person without an ID card. It is very, very complicated. I think
it's very complicated.
Yeah, I think that the message, the parliamentarians should really take it out on them, and also those of the opposition.
The government itself should, at least the police is also under the government, or is the government so is afraid to tell them to sit up?
Mr. Liu, I see that
that's evident.
The alleged sins of the 350 opposition parties are falling on the masses. Mm-hmm. Because the CPDM looks at it, it's looking at as if it's a game where they are playing it to their own interest and forgetting to understand that we have a nation to build. So it will still take a unison for us to understand that it's our nation, and it's going to take collective efforts of all Cameroonians to build this country to the direction it's supposed to go to. And I will lastly say again that development or change must not only come from the government. It can come from any angle equally as it can still come from the masses. So let Cameroonians work as Cameroonians and stand with Cameroonians in times of need and help also the government in doing certain things instead of waiting the government to come and
okay.
do for you.
Good evening, sir. I'm Vicky from Kumba. My ID card was to expire yesterday, 7, so I went to the police to extend the date, and they asked for 500 francs. It's not really easy, sir, please. ID card is like GCE exams, please. The government should do something, okay? You go for renewal, they're asking for money. Gwenten 6 is writing from Kumba. Greetings in the house, Mr. Liu. I'm a teacher in Mozogo, and my ID card was to expire in 2 days' time. I went to the police to extend it. They refused, in which I was to travel to Kumba from Mozogo to Douala. It's 3 days, and my ID card expired in Betwa. Mr. Liu, from that Betwa, I spent more than 10,000 francs before reaching Douala. Oops, c'est ça, c'est pas facile. Ok, Monsieur Youth, on espère que, comme le délégué général
national
a dit, les choses vont changer désormais.
Oui, nous restons confiants et puis nous devions continuer à croire à nos institutions. Parce qu'en réalité, si nos institutions ne sont pas fortes, notre République ne sera pas forte. Et nous devions saluer également cette disposition du gouvernement à pouvoir sécuriser la carte nationale d'identité. Parce qu'en réalité, souvenez-vous que nous avons connu le scandale où on disait qu'il y avait plein de un certain nombre de personnes qui prenaient des salaires pour d'autres, un certain nombre de personnes qui se faisaient payer par subtilisation de l'identification. Oui, oui, parce qu'en réalité, si vous n'avez pas la possibilité d'avoir le double de la carte nationale d'identité de M. Koumleo, Luna, ça voudrait dire que vous ne pouvez pas aller toucher à sa place. Donc, il faut que cela soit sécurisé. Donc, nous devrons rester confiants sur ce fait parce qu'en réalité, il y va même de la sécurité nationale.
Okay.
Donc, mais et nous devons tout simplement dire que mettons-nous à l'ouvrage et disons-nous que nous devrions croire en ce que ceci est en train d'être fait et cette prise en main et cette nouvelle technologie est pour les générations futures, y compris pour nous-mêmes. Je voulais juste dire un mot par rapport au massacre qui
on a observé. On devait parler de ça, mais... Mm-hmm.
Bon, mais tout simplement pour dire que le peuple camerounais est mature. Nos concitoyens des régions du Nord-Ouest et du Sud-Ouest sont en train de soutenir le gouvernement et vous êtes en train de constater que nous sommes passés d'une phase d'une confrontation armée-armée à une confrontation maintenant d'une guerre asymétrique qui est une guerre de terrorisme, donc c'est-à-dire de lâcheté. Ça montre que les forces de défense et de maintien de l'ordre sont en train de prendre le dessus et puis maintenant c'est la barbarie, le terrorisme qui est juste en train de vouloir s'installer aujourd'hui.
Okay.
Donc ce qui voudrait dire que l'ensemble des mesures de la résolution de cette crise qui sont en train d'être mises sur pied et qui ont été mises sur pied par le président de la République, y compris le statut spécial des régions du Nord-Ouest et du Sud-Ouest, qui va être un élément important pour que nous sachions effectivement
si la
décentralisation va être...
Oui. On espère que... Ouais. Hello, it's Ebay René from Limbe. The problem with ID card is not the president or Yaoundé. It's the police commissioner in the Nord-Ouest and Southwest. For example, they will collect 10,000 ID and send 1,000 to Yaoundé. The rest 9,000 will be left in the station, which you are forced to pay for another ID card. I'm writing from Half Mile in Limbe. Good evening, Mr. Liu. It's Mr. Wasum Achu from Yaoundé. How can they tell us that ID cards are all computerized, but when you lost your ID card and go for a new one, they will ask you to go start the process again? What is the meaning of that? That's a point. Good evening, Mr. Liu. Please, that the people should not saying that doesn't exist have been. Eric is writing from Douala. Good evening to you, Eric. Frank from Bamenda says they don't give us a way to have an ID and for to do the lost document for 2 years now that I can't get an ID to move around with a lost document. They still ask you to pay. We're living in my country with no fit. Frank from Bamenda. Good evening to you in the studio. I am Prophet Shepherd Prince, a Koje from Muyuka. What Ibako is saying is very correct, and it would also be good the government should put ID card production service in every region. Good evening, Mr. Leo Prince-Joel and all in the studio. It is with a heavy heart that a grown-up country like Cameroon still obstructs its citizens' access to identification. Getting an identification card in Cameroon is...
And to Prince Ekoso and to all the peace-loving people of Misaje.
Thank you for coming, Andre Atemebako.
Thank you very much, Mr. Leo.
Monsieur Youth, merci d'être venu. Hein.
Merci d'avoir convié une fois de plus sur le RLPC sur le plateau de votre chaîne et votre belle émission. Nous espérons que nous avons apporté un certain nombre de clarifications et nous espérons que nos concitoyens vont maintenant se rouer pour le retrait de leur carte nationale.
Ok, we're supposed to talk about the spiral of killings in Momo and today in Santa. We do not know what how the weekend is going to look like, but definitely on Monday we are going to be discussing about the security situation that is becoming the more preoccupying in the southwest and northwest region, knowing that there was an artisanal bomb that was neutralized yesterday in Kumba. We are going to be discussing on all of that on Monday. We want to thank the production team, to you Desmond, and to you Eli Noel Bertrand, and to you Tabby Tambe Bryant. We say good evening to you. Stay blessed. Bye-bye.